Welcome to Influence, the show about one of the university's founding colleges, the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. I'm your host, Emily Shaw. On this episode, we're going to continue learning about the Agricultural Education, Leadership, and Communications major. This week, we're going to learn more about the leadership concentration. And our first guest is Dr. Laura Greenhall, an assistant professor in the School of Human Sciences. Welcome, Dr. Greenhall.
Hi, thanks for having me.
We're excited to hear more about the concentration that you oversee, the Ag Leadership Concentration.
Absolutely. So obviously I'm biased. I think it's a great concentration. I have about 26 students in the concentration right now. We float around the 30 student area.
Sure.
I'm lucky enough that I get to advise all of them from an academic perspective. Yeah, it's a great concentration. It's the place to be.
Excellent. Tell us a little bit about the curriculum, kind of the diversity of the curriculum, and then maybe your what you would consider the primary courses to be a leadership student.
Yeah, so that's a great question. Obviously, in the degree of Ag Education, Leadership, and Communications, we match for all three concentrations to a certain extent. So we have the same Gen Ed core, we have the same Ag Education core. When I say ag education, meaning broad ag education. And then where we diverge is obviously in our leadership coursework. And so our leadership students will take classes in the College of Business, some courses that are designed to teach them either policy perspectives of leadership, some management perspectives of leadership, some ethics perspectives of leadership. And then my courses include things like team leadership and contemporary issues. And then the really cool thing about our concentration specifically is that there's about 30 hours of coursework where the student gets to dictate what they want to specialize in. So we feel like we turn out a really diversified student. It's hard to generalize what our students will do because they really do get to specialize in an area that makes a lot of sense to them and their career goals.
So based on that ability to specialize with your help, their curriculum, how does that influence their required internship?
Sure, so they all do a required internship, as you mentioned, and the 30 hours of coursework that they get to select really is intended to help them build a solid foundation of prerequisite work and then focus their upper level coursework in a specific area. So for example, if we had a student who is interested in going to work for a grain company, for example, Bungie or ADM, Archer Daniels Midland, they might take some lower level coursework in agriculture to kind of figure out where they best find their fit.
Right.
And then they'll use those focus hours, those 3,000, 4,000 level hours, to really dive deeply into coursework in grain crops and agronomy and plant soil sciences so that they not only come out with the human skills that we're giving them from a leadership perspective, but then they also have that solid technical content that those companies are looking for in their early hires and management trainee folks that they're bringing in.
That makes so much sense. So that's one great example. Where are some other places that your students have interned?
So we've had interns obviously in the extension system, both with specialists and with county agents.
Okay.
So those are two very different looks at extension. We've placed students with the USDA Farm Service Agency, with NRCS. I've had several students who intern with what used to be Crop Production Services and now recently became Nutrien. I have a lot of students who actually will do those internships and then that turns into a full-time position upon graduation. Several students in sales in different, different industries, different subsets of the ag industry. And so it really is incredibly diverse. I have students come to me and say, well, what can you really do with this degree?
Right.
And it sounds a little cliche, but I always start with whatever you want to. You really build it to fit what makes sense to you and what your aspirations are.
That's excellent. So some of those in their careers now, what are some additional places that they've gotten employment?
Sure. So I have students who are now working for Caterpillar in sales or as a tech representative. I have people who have gone into the cattle industry on the sales side. I have students who are working for cooperatives, cotton cooperatives in the state. I have a lot of students who have gone on to graduate programs at various institutions. and been very successful in those roles. And then as our concentration really was intended when it was started, I do have a lot of students who will end up in extension, not just in Mississippi, but I've had students go into extension in Arkansas and Louisiana, Alabama, and various places. So really, you tell me what you want to do and we'll figure out a way to build it.
It just definitely showcases the diversity, knowing where they've gone to work.
Absolutely.
So I want to circle back to your team leadership course, because
okay.
It's a service learning course.
It is.
So tell us what that looks like.
So this course didn't exist when I got here. Mm-hmm. The content actually came from the one course that we were teaching when I mm-hmm. did get here. So it's really based on a group dynamics textbook.
Okay.
And it is designed to help students learn how to function in teams.
Okay.
And so that kind of work is seen quite frequently around our industry.
Mm-hmm.
And so I early on decided that I wanted them to have that perspective. So we
right.
have a community partner, they are assigned a team, they develop a project, and they carry that out through the semester in a really real world, real life experience.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Dr. Greenhall. When we come back, we'll hear from a student in the leadership concentration.
Think you know ag? Think again.
We are creative.
We protect the environment.
We prepare for careers in medicine and conduct research.
We empower people and communities.
We are technology driven.
And we feed and clothe the world.
We are the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences at Mississippi State University.
Imagine a car designed to travel 100 miles on a single gallon of gas. Engineered to lead the way in energy independence. It will inspire you to rethink how cars actually work. Imagine the car of the future. We are at Mississippi State University, where we ring true.
Welcome back to Influence. Our next guest is Dixie Priest, a senior in the leadership concentration. Welcome, Dixie.
Hey.
We're so glad to have you, and I want to hear more about yourself and how you got to MSU.
Okay, I am from Pontotoc, Mississippi,
okay.
and I attended Itawamba Community College
mm-hmm.
for my first 2 years
okay.
out of high school, and I was majoring in business
okay.
when I was at ICC, but I decided that was not quite the fit that I wanted, and I've always been really, really, really like equine assisted therapy and hippo
okay.
therapy.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to think about going into occupational therapy.
Okay.
But I talked to several different people and they said, don't consider kinesiology, to have a backup plan. So I went for a major that I really enjoyed. I grew up in 4-H, I grew up on a small farm, and I talked to Dr. Laura Greenhall and she really convinced me of the great aspects of an agricultural leadership major.
Excellent. So having an agricultural background certainly helped to get you this way, I
yes,
think.
Yes, ma'am. It
Excellent.
Did.
So I know that you have already completed your internship, so tell us a little bit
yes,
about
ma'am.
That.
I interned with Dr. Dean Josan,
mm-hmm.
and he's here in the Animal and Dairy Science Department. A lot of what we did was helping with the Dixie National Livestock Show,
okay.
and so I got a lot of leadership experience mm-hmm. through that.
Excellent. I know that you're also one of our undergraduate research scholars,
yes,
and you're participating in that this semester, or this year, academic year, rather.
Yes,
and that ties into something you've already mentioned. So tell us about that project and what all it's going to entail.
So since my career goal is occupational therapy, I decided that, and I want to bring hippotherapy in it, so I want to bring the agriculture aspect into that. When Dr. Greenhall presented me with the opportunity to do some undergrad research, I immediately wanted to do hippotherapy.
Okay.
And what we are looking for is the effects of two silent laps prior to the lesson on children with autism.
Okay.
If it actually does benefit them and promote their stimulation, or if it shows no difference. So this first semester, we are going straight into the lesson. We have the sidewalkers talk to them. Mm-hmm. We immediately start their lesson. They start whatever activities they're doing that day. And then next semester, we will be completely quiet, silent, two laps around the arena, and then we'll begin the lesson. And so we're hoping that we will see some really great results from this.
Excellent. So just in case some of our viewers don't know what hippotherapy is, tell us a little bit about that.
So hippotherapy is when an occupational or physical therapist, they work together and implement a plan for a child with special needs and a horse, and they work together. A lot of their core muscle strengthening, and the horse really simulates the girdle movement of a human. And so that really helps. And sometimes they pull a speech language pathologist in as well.
Mm-hmm.
And that also, they all have to work together.
Excellent. So, I'm guessing a lot of people don't think about the opportunities like that are available to the therapeutic riding, and that's where your research takes place. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Excellent. So very interesting combination. It really portrays what you can do with a leadership concentration. So just lastly, what do you want to do ultimately with this agricultural and occupational therapy mix? Will it be more therapeutic riding? What kind of things?
I would like to become an occupational therapist and specialize in hippotherapy.
Okay.
Also, I would love to open up my own facility.
Mm-hmm.
And so the agriculture background will really help with that. And maybe kind of do like a agritourism business.
Excellent.
Combine it.
Sure.
And so that's my plan.
Excellent. Dixie, we'll be excited to hear what's next for you.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us on this episode of Influence, where we learned more about the Ag Education, Leadership, and Communications major, specifically our Ag Leadership concentration. Thank you. See you next time.